Hey there guys, Paul here from theengineeringmindset.com. In this video, we are going to be looking at FCUs. FCU stands for fan coil unit. Now, fan coil units are very common in all types of buildings, from offices, bars, canteens, even some homes and maybe apartments will have a fan coil unit in them. Fan coil units are used to condition the local air to suit the temperature requirements of the immediate space. So as you can see in this model here, we've got this space here and there's a fan coil unit in there with the ductwork going off to feed the various parts. And then on the fan coil unit, we've got these pipes running to it, which are the cooling and heating coils inside, and the air which is being supplied to there is being treated and distributed through these local ductworks to supply the required air. So in this building model here, you can see we've got the main AHU here, and that's supplying fresh air through this main duct all the way along to the rooms. And branches will come off of this and they will feed fresh air into the space. Each space will need a certain amount of fresh air per hour entering into the space. So you'll have a branch coming off and that will feed the fresh air into there. So this fresh air is directed into the inlet of the fan coil unit, and it's usually not connected though, there's a gap in between, there is a reason for that which we'll look at later. And so that fresh air enters into the box, it gets sucked inside here as a fan, we'll have a look inside that shortly, and that air gets heated or cooled and pushed out through these diffusers into the space. Now some of that air will recirculate up through the false ceiling, through those grills we looked at, and into back into this box here, whereas some of the air will be picked up into this return duct and that will be sucked by a fan here and pushed out of the building. So the fan coil units are located up in the ceiling. So this is a false ceiling in a typical office, and here you can see these diffusers. These are the supply diffusers, so that treated tempered air is being supplied into this office here, where it can circulate there and all of it gets sent back up through these return grills. If that false ceiling wasn't there, it would look something like this. So we've got a fan coil unit and we've got these the ductwork which is supplying the air. These are also diffusers, they're just slightly different from the square ones we saw just a second ago. So this fan coil unit is sucking up all the air in this space and it's passing it across here, there's a fan inside, and it's pushing it across a heating and cooling coil which treats the air to the right temperature that it's set to for this area, and that air is then pushed out through these ductworks to be supplied out through these diffusers where they're required. So this is the supply duct here, and as you can see the fresh air is coming in and it's entering into the space above this false ceiling here into the void above there. Now this fresh air enters into the fan coil unit and passes through the fan, there's a filter etc, we'll have a look at that in a moment also. Once that air is treated to the temperature it requires, it's then pushed out through the diffusers and out into the space. That pushes the air in the room, the dirty and the kind of used air, up, and that will then push this through the return grill and back into the ceiling void. Now that air is mixed again with some fresh air and pushed through, so that loop continues. Meanwhile, some of this return air that enters into this void is actually sucked up by this duct here. So any air that makes it to this part will be sucked out and that will be pushed out back out to atmosphere. Let's just have a look inside a fan coil unit to see some of its components. So if we remove the lid, we can have a look at the inside of the fan coil unit, and as you can see it's actually fairly simple in design. So this is the air inlet, so it comes through this face here. This is just a removable filter, so the filters look something like this. They can just be pulled off and they can just be cleaned or they can be replaced, and that just tries to stop the dust and stuff coming in, because that's going to be sent out through the local ductwork around the office. So the filters are just there to try and clean some of that air and remove the dust. Once that air is pulled through the filters, into the space here, it enters into the fans. Now in the fan cool unit, you can have just one fan, there may be two fans, there may be three fans, there could be more. But two fans is fairly common in fan cool units. So driving these is a small motor in the middle there. So that motor there is just located in the middle, and that is connected to the fan blades inside the fans. Now these fans are usually quite small, maybe around 80 watts or something like this, and they've got this shaft through the middle. And so on this you can connect multiple fans, so you might have some fan blade cage here and another one on this side. They could even be extended to have a third cage on there as well. So that air is then forced by these fans out here and then into this box here. This part here contains the heating and cooling coils. Now the heating and cooling coils, they just heat the air up or cool it down depending on the requirements for the local environment. You may have just one coil in there, it could just be a cooling coil or it could just be a heating coil, or you may have both of them like this where the air can be heated or cooled. So these coils are fed, say this one's the heating coil here, so this is fed hot water from the boiler, and this coil here is the cooling one, so this is fed cold water from the chiller. So we just change the view there. So now the air is coming through here, and imagine it's coming towards the screen. So if this was the heating coil, then hot water is going to be entering through this pipe here, and it makes its way all the way around, and as it does so it loses some of its heat, or if it was the cooling coil as well, as that loses some of its thermal energy and transfers that over into the air which is being forced out towards the screen, and that's what changes the temperature of the air. Now if you are cooling the air using a cooling coil, then you are going to generate quite a bit of condensation. So as that warm air is being picked up from the space and being pushed by this fan into the heating and cooling chamber, when it hits the coil it's going to start to condense if you're cooling it. So this water, which will run off, and it will collect in this drip tray at the bottom here, and so you also need a pipework to take that water away. And in the right months, in the summer, for etc. in the UK, that's really going to be quite a lot of water you're generating. But after the air has passed across these coils, it enters into the discharge plenum, and this is what is connected to the local ductwork and to the diffusers. So you may have many holes on here, and these will all be sent off through ductwork out to wherever it's required. This is how the fans will look in the real world. So here we've got the two fan chambers mounted to one motor, and here we've got just a single fan with its very own motor. Now the cooling coils, well, the heating and cooling coils, do not necessarily have to be on this side of the fan. It kind of varies by manufacturer. So these coils could also be before the fans, so that the air is coming in, passing through the filter, passes over the coils first, and then is sucked by the fans and pushed out. But this is a very common example. Now I've put in this model that there are the coils, and that there's water passing through these to give up the temperature as required. You may also find that there's an AC unit, a refrigerant, doing exactly the same job as this one, and the heating one could be electric also. It usually depends on the size and location of the fan coil and the room. But this water type is very common in large buildings, especially office buildings. So looking at this schematic here of how the fan cool units work, so we've got the main AHU over here, and that's supplying the air down through these ducts, and it's supplying each of the rooms. Now not all of the fan cool units will have this fresh air duct to them. You can see this one here does not have that. However, each room will have a fresh air connection, because there is a requirement obviously for each room to have a certain amount of fresh air per hour. So that fresh air is supplied, and you can see in this example it's coming through this duct here. And this is the filter, this is the inlet for the fan coil unit. So it's not connected, and that air will be blown onto here, but also into the void. That filter can just be removed. You can see here it's slightly not joined there. So this can just be pulled off or slid out, depending on the design. And that can either be cleaned or just thrown away and replaced with a new one. And you can see a slightly different view there. So again, we've got the fan coil unit there with the air entering, and this is the fresh air being supplied here. And the tempered air is leaving and coming out through these ducts here. You can also tell it's tempered by these colored arrows here pointing in the direction of the flow and indicating that the air could be hot or cold. Now, on the coils, if they are supplied by hot or chilled water, then as you can see here, so we've got the boiler, which is feeding into the AHU for the main one. And it also has a flow and return pipe, and that runs along the ceiling and connects and branches off to each of the fan coil units. There's also a chiller, and this is providing chilled water off to the main AHU and then down into each of the fan coil units as well. So up in the ceiling, you're going to see a lot of pipes like this. So here you can see we've got the heating flow, so that's going this way in the direction of the arrows. The colored bands also indicate this. And then we've got the return. So once that is given up its heat, it comes back and heads back to the boiler. Again on this one, so we've got the chilled water flow. So it's flowing in this direction. I think the arrow is actually wrong there, but and then with the chilled water return here as well. So this is going to the fan coil units, and this is returning and going to the chiller. And these connections look something like this, where they're connecting off into the coils. And you can see here them just branching off there from the main risers that pass along the ceiling. And these are just branching off and feeding into the fan coil unit. Now the main AHU that's supplying all the fresh air for the building into the spaces, this does not necessarily have to have these additional requirements in there for heating and cooling coils. It could just be 100% fresh air being pushed in and pushed out. So it could be something just like this, where the air is passing straight in, off into the spaces, and that air is then picked up and sent and pushed out of the building. You'll probably just have some filters on the supply there though. But you're still going to have your connections to the chillers and the boilers feeding off onto the fan coil units, unless of course your cooling is supplied by a refrigeration unit and the heating could be electric. Okay, that is it for this video on fan coil units. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this and this has helped you. If it has, don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Any questions, please leave them in the comment section below and we'll try to answer them as soon as possible. Visit our website, theengineeringmindset.com. We're also on Facebook, Google and Twitter.